between 1/3 and 1/2 of the world's population do not have any infrastructure for cooking. They continue cooking as did our ancestors more than 100 years ago, with just using biomass, wood, coal, to cook food for the family. So this occupation today can take up 2 entire days a week just going out to get firewood. I was up in the Sahel region of the Ivory Coast, and my task was to improve the lives of women that had the ability to earn a small income from artisanal work. In the end, they had no time to do this work because they were burdened with looking for firewood to be able to cook food for their families and heat water for bathing. That's what actually got me started in looking for a solution. And of course, this, even though this was quite a long time ago, there was already the huge concern of deforestation. I read about solar cooking in the newspaper when I was living in Switzerland. I had my eureka moment and said, aha, that's the solution. Solar cooking isn't new. It's been around for probably 20 or 30 years. It has acquired a bad reputation because a lot of the projects that tried to introduce it didn't invest the time and money in the training element. They gave the technology to people thinking that they would just know how to use it. And now we're dealing with rural populations that don't go out and buy a whole lot of new products. These are people with a very small income. Even in rural Mexico, if people can scramble together $3 to $5 a day, they feel very lucky. And so putting together enough money to actually buy a $35 solar cooker, and they've never heard of solar cooking, is something they're just not going to do. It's too risky.
Mi nombre es Obdulia Acuña.
Yo soy Norma Suárez.
Nosotros quedamos, mi compañera y yo, para capacitar a otras personas, incluso en otras comunidades. De aquí salimos casa por casa visitándolas para ver si le están dando uso a los hornos solares.
We have trainers in different parts of Mexico who are local trainers. Part of our introductory program is to set up a demonstration in a village, and you set up maybe 5 or 10 pots, and in each pot you're cooking something different, and you have a training manual and visuals to show to people how is this working. And when they look in the pot, they see the food cooking, they see the water boiling, they see that raw chicken that is now being cooked, or the vegetables that are being cooked, or the bread that's baking, they see it. She's primary goal is to get entrepreneurs to look at solar cooking as a lucrative business. We haven't gotten there yet, but that is our long-term goal. We see that the world's petroleum resources are diminishing and the prices are increasing. Every family using petroleum products knows exactly how much they're spending every month. So there's this awareness, and people will be very careful about saving. The huge portion of the world that is obliged to live with $1 a day. Those people often have to choose on spending that dollar on food or on fuel, because there's not enough for both. We have quotes from people that say, I can no longer afford fuel. I can't cook anymore. I'm going to have to eat avocados and bread. So there are health implications and financial implications that are very significant. Entrepreneurs get a wind of this, that people can cook with their, they can cook a portion of their meals, their daily meals, 1 or 2 meals a day without spending any money at all, because they're using the sun as a source of fuel, that they can reduce their cost for gas enough to pay for the solar cooker. That it would be a lucrative business to get into.